Yo guys, so today seems like a good day. The sun is shining, so I thought I might take my car for a drive. Also, I'm going to visit a friend of mine. He did mention he's busy respraying another friend of ours rims. Apparently it's some mad color, so I'll show you guys in a bit. And then also just wanted to share with you guys the next possible mod I'll be adding to my car. Sorry for the fine. This is Momo Hooter. So you guys might assume that yes, this might be a downgrade. Let me just explain. So the reason for me buying this, okay, actually not buying, it's kind of some type of scam. A friend of mine taught me. If you go to Chinatown, they do not sell these. This does, however, come with a steering wheel. So you have to remove this out of the box and then ask the Chinese lady to sell you this. She just wants money, so she will charge you basically 100 rand for this. So the whole idea with this is to remove this cover over here and then fit another gel badge over here. So yes, you might assume maybe this is a better looking one. However, I am going with the with the Spoon logo. So let me just show you guys. So this is a Spoon logo. My friend makes this. He had an extra one, so he basically gave it to me. So thanks to him, Tariq. So basically what I'm going to do is remove mine and then put this one onto the Momo one that I got from Chinatown. So let me just explain to you guys the reason for doing this. Spoon, they use the exact same steering wheel. This is the Momo Monte Carlo steering wheel. The only difference is that they have the red stitching over here, and then basically the Hooter is different. So unfortunately I will not have the red stitching, but I'm going to put the Spoon Hooter in so that it kind of looks like a Spoon steering wheel. And as you guys know, I am kind of going for the whole Spoon theme. So I'll just show you guys how I do that in the next vlog. Stay tuned for that, guys. Hope you can hear me. So this is my friend Dane. He usually helps me with the spraying. Apparently he says that this rim looks black, but if you shine it kind of has a blue, what do you call it, blue base coat?
Blue pearl.
Blue pearl. So you guys can't really see right now, but I'll show you in the sun or when the clear is on.
Hey guys, let me just explain to you quickly.
So this 25% means that, and this 50% means basically that this is black paint, but with 25% pearl and 50% pearl. I'll just show you guys in sunlight. Unfortunately, you can't see it so good because there's no clear on it. But I'll show you guys 100%. Hopefully you guys can see it better. So this is the 100%. In the dark, this, like I mentioned, is black paint with 100% pearl. Let me just show you in the sunlight. Hope you guys can see it properly. Okay, there's a better look at it. Can you guys see the pearl? Please do mention in the comment section if you guys do like this blue pearl. The car that it's going to be on is for an FK2. The rims will basically be black. The rims were silver, so basically gunmetal. So it will be now black with this type of blue pearl in it. Hope you guys like it.
Several days later.
Welcome back to the vlog. So today we'll be working on the EK. I actually have my cousin's car. He doesn't know I have his car. Thought I'd surprise him today by cleaning his engine bay, because our electricity is off in our area. So I thought instead of just sitting around, I might as well just clean the engine bay, seeing that it does need a bit of a clean. I'm just going to a friend of mine. He does have a pressure hose as well as he has electricity. So we are basically going to clean the engine bay by his house and surprise my cousin with a new engine bay clean. Like I did mention in the previous vlog, the engine bay is pretty dirty. So we're just going to clean the engine bay. So just another advice, I always use this part over here. If you do use the top one, it kind of bends the bonnet. So I always use this one. And then also just want to inform you guys that when you do clean the engine bay, the drizzy must be covered, as well as the fuse box over there. As you can see, the engine bay is pretty dirty, as well as the bonnet. We're going to use some oven cleaner. As well as, sorry, just mentioned, you guys also need to remove the induction. So obviously you would not want to suck any water into the motor. Also guys, you're probably also gonna need a pressure hose in order for you to do this. It's the one we're using. Done, engine bay doesn't look much cleaner. My cousin is not aware that we're doing this, but it's something that we need to do. So I'm just going to take the filter off quickly and maybe just cover up the drizzy and the fuse box. Set you guys up in a time lapse. As you can see, my hand is already dirty just touching the filter. So guys, this is what it needs to look like before you start. We just cover up this over here. As you can see, the drizzy is closed. You can use any plastic bag. This is the oven cleaner, no?
Oven cleaner, yeah.
Then how much does that that 5 liter go for?
45 rand. Cheap. These people lost forever, man.
Kind of clean the bonnet. You can see the one side. It's much cleaner than the other side. And this is the engine bay. What you also notice, the oven cleaner kind of takes off the black. So we might just have to spray the tapper cover. We do plan on spraying the silver black in the future anyway. And as you can see, everything seems a bit much cleaner than it was before. Okay guys, so we're just using a compressor to blow everything dry. Engine bay looks much clean. Guys, I would recommend you guys use AutoSol just to clean the induction pipe. It helps with the tail pieces as well. Guys, this is only a temporary fix, but I was saying I actually like the logos being black instead of it being silver again. Just gonna see if the car is going to still start. So, moment of truth. So it still starts. You guys would just want to maybe just have it idle for a bit as well.